Hello students, welcome to Dynamics of Machinery. We are in Module 2, Dynamic Force Analysis. In the first part of this module, we have did dynamic force analysis on the four-bar chain mechanism and we solved one problem. In the previous class, I gave introduction to this topic, force analysis on bevel gear. Okay. In bevel gear, suppose a gear and pinion is mating with each other, means two kind of forces might be involved there. One is separating force and another one is tangential force. This separating force is further classified into axial component and then radial component. All these things we have seen in the previous video. So to find out the distance, average distance, you have the formula R average equal to R minus B sine gamma divided by 2. So this is gamma sine gamma. Okay, this is also gamma. This is not R. This is gamma. Okay. This is gamma. Remember, this is not R, this is gamma. So we got this formula in the previous video itself. So we are going to solve problem based on this formula. So R average equal to R minus B sine gamma divided by 2. So now transmitted torque will be equal to T equal to Ft into R average. Ft means tangential force. Otherwise, Ft equal to T by R average. So this Fs separating force. Fs, I told you, this further divided into Fr and Fa. Fr means radial component. This Fs. Fs is further divided into Fr and Fe. Fs equal to Ft into tan pi. Okay. So this pi also we have to find out. Okay. We will solve this problem. Two 20 degree straight bevel gears have a module pitch of 4 mm. And 24 and 48 teeth respectively. The tooth face width is 50 mm. The pinion rotates at 1000 rpm and transmits 5 kilowatt. The shafts are at 90 degree. Determine the components of gear force and show these on a sketch of the gears. So here pi. This is pi value. Okay, they are given pi value 20 degree. What is they are given? They are given number of teeth in pinion and the number of teeth in pinion is 24. Number of teeth in gear is 48. Okay, and it rotates at the speed of 1000 rpm. Okay. What is they given? They are given the power. Okay, power which it transmits. Power is equal to 5 kilowatt. Okay. So we have to find out the radius value. No, we have to find out the radius value. To find out the radius value, they are given the module value, they are given the module value, module pitch of 4 mm. Module is equal to 4 mm. Okay. So this is the formula for that. Radius equal to module into number of teeth in pinion divided by 2. Actually the formula is m equal to d by t. In the previous sum we have studied, no, module equal to d by t or d by t. Okay, so module value is 4, that is equal to, we will take this d by t, capital D by t. Capital D value we don't know, that we have to find out, but capital T value 48. So capital D equal to 48 into 4. Okay. Similarly, m equal to d by t. So 4 equal to, what is d value that we have to find out? Small t value 24. So 4 into 24. D equal to 4 into 24. 4 into 24, what is the value? I think 96. Okay. 96 you will get. Okay. What we need? We need R value. So R equal to D by 2. 96 divided by 2. 48. Okay. Similarly, here if you calculate means D value will be 4 into 48. 4 into 48 is 96, 192. Okay. So capital R value will be D by 2, 192 divided by 2. Okay. D by 2, that is 192 divided by 2, the value will be 96. 96 m, here 48 m. Okay, see, for module I have used the symbol m. Okay, here also they have used the symbol m only, but for diameter they have used the symbol z. Okay, but I have used dp. So we got the values 48 m and 96 m. To find out the gamma value, we know the formula. Gamma equal to tan inverse of small r divided by capital R. Okay, so small r value is 48 m, capital R value is 96. So gamma value is 26.56 degree. What else we need? We have to find out R average. First of all, we will read the question again. What we have to find out? We have to find out, determine the components of the gears of forces and show these on the sketch of gears. So I forgot to tell you these things now. So we have to find out Fn Ft. Further, this Fn is classified into F axial, F radial. So we have to find out these forces, F axial, F radial, and then F tangential. We have to find out these three forces, or along with the Fn, four forces. Okay, we have to find out. Okay, for that, first of all, we have to find out the radius. They didn't give the radius. Okay, in the problem, they didn't give the radius. They just give the number of teeth. They just give the number of teeth and pressure angle and speed and then power they have given. Okay, they have just given the power value. Okay, power value is 5 kW. Okay, this is what they have given. These are the given datas. These are the given datas. And these are the datas we have to find out. F axial, F radial, F tangentials. Okay, these are the forces we have to find out. Okay, so we are proceeding from here. First of all, they given the module value. Module equal to D by T or D by T. The capital D by capital T or small d by small t. That is diameter teeth ratio. That is called as module. okay, our diameter teeth ratio is called as module. So 4 equal to capital D by 48. So capital D equal to 192. If diameter is 192, means radius will be half of the diameter, 96 mm. Okay. Similarly here, once again, m equal to small d by small t. Small d value we have to find. Small t value 24. So small d value is 96. Okay, we got 96. D equal to 24 into 4, 96. Okay. So r equal to d by 2, 48 mm. Okay, 48 mm. We got the answer for small radius. Small radius, capital radius. We got the answers. Okay. Now next we have to find out psi value. Next we have to find out psi value. To find out the psi value, formula is tan inverse of small r divided by capital R, 48 by 96. So psi value is gamma value is 26.56. Okay. Next we have to find out cone distance. Yeah, we have to find out cone distance. If we find the cone distance, means then we have to find out mean radius, then average radius, then angular speed of the pinion. This is not diameter. This is not diameter. This is cone distance. Okay, they are using the same word again. Okay, otherwise you just mention like this DC. Yeah. First we have to find out cone distance, then minimum radius, average radius. Okay. So if we found these things, means then we can easily find the answer. Okay. So for finding the cone distance, a formula is root of capital R square minus small r square. So this is the formula for cone distance, DC. Okay. So the value is 107.33 mm. Then we have to find out minimum radius. Minimum radius formula is cone distance minus 50 into sine gamma. Okay, well? Tooth face width, that you have to mention as b. Small b equal to 50 mm. So here next to r mean equal to dc minus b into sine gamma. Yeah, so dc value is 107.33. B value is given in the question, 50. Sine gamma. Gamma value is 26.56 that we got in the previous step. Okay. So R mean value is 25.53. Next, R average. R average equal to, R average formula is equal to pinion radius plus R mean divided by 2. Okay, pinion radius plus R mean. So you will get 36.82 as the answer. Yeah. Next step, we have to find out torque. So you have to find out torque, means we know that power equal to, these formulas we know in the previous sum we have studied these things, 2 pi n t divided by 60. Okay, power equal to 2 pi n t divided by 60. So otherwise we can say like this, power equal to 2 pi n by 60 means omega, no, omega into t. Okay, either way you can write. Okay, omega means 2 pi n by 60. So 2 into pi into omega means 2 pi n by 60. 2 into pi into 1000 divided by 60. For omega you got the answer as 104. Okay, so power is 5 kilowatt. Okay, power is 5 kilowatt. So in the question they are given, 5 into 10 power 3 equal to, omega value is 104.72 into T. So torque we got as 47.75 newton. Okay. So we got the torque value. Next, using torque value, we can find out FT value, tangential force. Torque by R average equal to FT. Torque by R average equal to FT. So 1296. Next, using FT, we can find out FR and FA, radial force and axial force. For radial force, formula is FT into tan pi cos alpha. For axial force, formula is FT into tan pi sin alpha. That's all. Yeah. So we got the answer 412 and 211. Now you have to draw the diagram. Draw the diagram. Okay. Draw the diagram because they told us to draw the diagram. Draw this bevel gear arrangement. Okay. You just draw it roughly, but using scale and pencil, you draw it. Okay. It doesn't mean that you have to draw 48 centimeter line or 4.8 centimeter line. Just draw similar line. At least you can draw this here to here. Draw 10 centimeter line here to here. Draw 20 centimeter line. Or if you want to draw according to the dimension, no problem. You just draw it. Okay. If you want to draw according to the dimension, no problem. You just draw according to the dimension. Okay. If you want to draw according to dimension, means here to here, you draw 9.6 centimeter. Here to here, you have to draw 19.2 centimeter. Yeah, because radius is 48, so diameter will be 96, so 9.6. Here radius is 96, diameter will be 192, so 19.2. Like that, you just draw. Okay, and then this distance is 107. Okay, this distance is 107 from this point to this point. 107 means 10.7. Okay, 10.7. Or you just connect these two points. You just connect this point and this point like this. Afterwards, using scale, here to here 5 centimeter. Mark it. Here to here 5 centimeter. Similarly, here to here also 5 centimeter. Okay, you mark it. Then this angle gamma we got, no, 26.56. okay, take that angle and draw a line like this. That's all, your diagram will be over now. Okay, this is a sketch. This is what they told. Okay, I'm telling you again. Let me erase it and I will explain you again. Wait for a while, let me explain it again. Okay, so here they are given a set of bevel gears with the angle pi value is given. Data is pi value is 20 degree. Okay, and then module is 4 mm. Okay, wow. Then small t equal to 24, capital T equal to 48. What is they given? they are given base width b equal to 50 mm. Okay, what is they are given? They are given speed value. Speed value is 1000 rpm. Okay, what is they are given? They are given power value. Power value is 5 kW. Okay, then shafts are at 90 degrees with each other. This is what they are given. What we have to find out? We have to find out the components of the gear force. What are the components? So here you write given data. Here you write given data. Now to find. Now what you have to find? FT. What is FT value? FR. FE. Tangential component, radial component, axial component. This is what you have to find out. Okay. So before we proceed to the formulas, first of all we have to find out diameter of the pinion and the diameter of the or radius of the pinion and the radius of the gear. We have to find out. For that they are given the module. So module equal to capital D by capital T equal to capital small d by small t. So module value is 4. So capital D divided by capital T. Capital T is 48. So capital this D value is 192 mm. So capital radius will be half of the diameter value, 96 mm. Now similarly here 4 equal to small d by small t. Small t value is 24. So small d value will be 96 mm. Small r value will be half of the 96, that is 48 mm. Yeah, now we got this diameter and all those things. Similarly, what else we have to find out? We have to find out gamma value. To find out gamma value, formula is tan inverse of small r divided by capital R. Your gamma value is tan inverse of small r divided by capital R. Small r value is 48, capital R is 96, that is 1/2. So gamma value is around 26 degrees. Okay, around 26 degrees, we got it. Okay, next, what details we need? We have to find out torque value. So far before that, to find out torque value, the formula: power equal to 2 pi nt divided by 60, where 2 pi n by 60 means omega. So for that n value, you substitute all the values. Okay, what is the power? Power is 5 kilowatts. 5 kilowatts means 5 into 10 power 3 equal to 2 into pi into n value. N value is 1000 rpm into t divided by 60. So you can get the torque value. Okay, you can get torque value. After getting torque value, what else we have to find? We have to find out. We need R average. Still we need R average. To find out that, first of all we have to find out diameter of the cone. Diameter of the cone equal to capital R square minus small r square. So we got the answer is 107. Next, we need R mean. Okay, R mean means this DC minus B. DC minus B equal to R mean into sine 26, that is sine comma. Okay, if you substitute means, you will get 25.63 as a value. Next, R average. R average equal to R plus R mean by 2. R value is 48. R mean is 25.63. So if you substitute 36.82. Also we got torque value 47.75. Now we have to substitute everything in the formula. For FT, formula is T by R average. For FR, formula is FT into tan pi cos gamma. For FA, axial force, formula is FT tan pi sin gamma. That's all. Now we have to draw the diagram. Okay, now we have to draw the diagram. Now we will draw the diagram. First, you draw this vertical line. Okay, radius value is 48. So this diameter value will be 96. So draw a vertical line for 9.6 centimeter. And then here capital R is 96. So capital D will be 192. So draw horizontal line for 19.2 centimeter. Yeah. Now connect this two end with the light line, light line like this. Yeah. Thin line. Now for 5 centimeter draw thick line. Okay. Here also for 5 centimeter draw thick line. From the midpoint, draw reference line, and for this line, gamma 26 degree. Keep your protractor on this line. Okay, keep your protractor on this line and take 26 degree and mark the point and connect the line. And here draw 5 centimeter line. Now connect it. Mark this R mean, R average, okay, and then this D value, the DC, diameter of the cone, DC value. Okay, that's all. Problem is over. Very simple problem. Surely they might ask in university exam. So solve it and upload it in the Google Classroom and get attendance.